Yes, sir, we promised you a great main event here tonight.
Andre, the champ.
WrestleMania.
WrestleMania is running west.
My God, what a
Santino was fired by Donald Trump when he used to on the show.
I'm surprised to see a smile on Santino's face. He's been pretty distraught, pretty upset over that. He has to only he only keeps up with his sister now by a cell phone and tweets. He said he tweets her.
What do you know about that?
What, Twitter? You don't Twitter?
And from Venice, California, weighing in at 184 pounds,
I know this. That outfit would look good on you.
Okay.
Well, it would look good on somebody.
So Santino did the kickoff superstars against the Brian Kendrick here. And, you know, we mentioned Donald Trump a few moments ago. What an impact Donald Trump has had on Raw in the short time that he owned the show. I mean, came up with a guest host idea, engineered a big trade, and, of course, he sold the show back to Mr. McMahon a couple of weeks ago.
At double his money. That's truly the art of the deal. Donald is something. Did you take notes while we were here?
I was trying. Financial whiz. Mr. McMahon not too happy that he had to pay twice as much to get his Raw franchise back. So the odd, eccentric Brian Kendrick, I guess you could use those adjectives to describe Santino as well.
Lee Brian Kendrick trying to start things off with a little fancy footwork there.
Listen to our fans here.
And a bit embarrassed, I believe, Santino, from the cheers.
Got used to the, adulation, I guess.
Santino, a two-time Intercontinental Champion. Brian Kendrick, a tag team champion. Great athlete is Kendrick and Santino, for that matter.
Man, that's a tough hold. If I were the referee, I think I'd check that. It looks suspiciously like it could be a chokehold.
Both these superstars.
Up on a chin.
Trying again to improve their standing on Raw.
Whoa!
A lot of changes on Monday nights over the past few weeks. And later tonight, we're going to show you what happened this past Monday night on Raw. And the huge main event set up for this coming week. Santino, nice takedown of the Brian Kendrick.
Santino with that old school side headlock and doing some damage with it.
You know, can we laugh a lot at Santino and some of the things he's done? But he does have some good ability in the ring.
Well, he's good ability. And you know what this guy, I mean, there's a for a break there. Kendrick taking the easy way out by getting outside those ropes. I mean, Santino's got a lot of charisma. And that's, you know, that's very, very important when you're a WWE superstar.
I don't know who he was talking to or what he was saying, but...
Sometimes I'd call his wrestling ability mediocre, but why be kind? No, no, wait a minute. He's going to impress us here.
Trying to skin the cat.
Oh!
for Santino. A lot of the good stuff he tries backfires.
Brian Kendrick now has targeted the leg of Santino. Kendrick, a great athlete in his own right. So quick in the ring. Really has a vicious mentality and attitude. See the aggressiveness.
The Brian Kendrick is, Michael, you're going to have to start sticking the word "the" in front of that. He chastised me about that a couple of weeks ago.
Right, for not saying
the Brian Kendrick, yeah. I guess there's certainly only one Brian Kendrick, and he is the one.
Continuing to work on the leg of Santino. Santino in a big predicament here. WWE Universe trying to will Santino back into this matchup. Ooh, and right back to the leg goes Kendrick.
Man. Santino in a lot of pain right now. Santino, I think he's heard enough. Oh, just embarrassing and insulting slaps.
But Kendrick's still mocking Santino.
Santino's a "now you made me so mad."
Well, he's had tucks to big punches, and here comes Santino.
What about that move?
I don't think Brian Kendrick saw any of this coming. What a hip toss.
Santino's kind of bendy. Did you see that nice little maneuver?
Gumby-like. A little out of control, and Kendrick looks for the win as he hooks the leg on Santino.
Santino's don't get mad. Kendrick, that's the same thing you did earlier. No, he's got the
rope. And Santino from behind the Brian Kendrick, though.
Going for a roll up there, didn't work.
Shoulders down, Santino.
Hey!
Look at the reversal.
Nice
Santino,
move.
Shoulders down on Kendrick. He got him. Can't believe it.
I don't think Santino can believe it.
Congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations.
Good for you.
Today was my day. Today was my day.
He's saying today was his day.
Right. Brian Kendrick, earlier on he was embarrassing Santino. He was embarrassed here tonight.
I cried. He's too angry.
Well, watch this. Let's take a look back as Santino had things going his way, but then, man, a face full of boot from the Brian Kendrick. Santino went for a roll-up. That was foiled. And then look at this. Watch this reversal. Great move by Santino Marella. And he got the victory. Truly Santino's day.
Big win here on WWE Superstars for one Santino Marella. But, King, we have an absolutely huge main event here tonight on WGN America.
Are you kidding me? The World Heavyweight Champion squares off against one half of the new Unified Tag Team Champions as CM Punk goes against Edge right here tonight on Superstars.
This contest is set for one fall. Currently in the ring from Dallas, Texas, weighing 249 pounds, Charlie Haas.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for watching WWE Superstars representing SmackDown. My name is Todd Grisham alongside Hall of Famer, good old JR Jim Ross. And to say this has been a turbulent week in the WWE, well, that's not the right word. It's been insane, hasn't it?
I like turbulence when I'm not on a plane. It has been a great week here in WWE.
Weighing 224 pounds, John Morrison.
So here comes John Morrison, who is still a member of SmackDown, but 15 superstars were traded this week, thanks in part to Donald Trump.
I'm sure glad that John Morrison stayed on Friday night SmackDown. And last Friday night on SmackDown, John Morrison had an amazing one-on-one match with the World Heavyweight Champion CM Punk. As a matter of fact, ladies and gentlemen, let's take you back to that footage and show you what some people would say maybe is an upset. I don't think so. Not with the upside of John Morrison.
Well, anytime you beat the World Heavyweight Champion, you should shout to the hills about it. And that's exactly what John Morrison did.
And, of course, look at this great counter right here. Both arms underhooked. Now, this is before CM Punk had the eye injury at the Bash on Sunday.
But then after the match, frustration setting in for CM Punk, who hit the go-to-sleep on Morrison. And that's really uncharacteristic of what we've seen from the straight-edge superstar.
And the complexity of the situation further compounded by CM Punk looking to be very frustrated at himself for his own actions. Be that as it may, this should be a fast-paced, one-fall matchup here on WGN America.
And CM Punk, the World Heavyweight Champion, still after the Bash. He'll be in action later tonight in our main event right here on WGN America.
Yeah, here's the Edge. What about that? Edge and CM Punk right here tonight.
Right now, though, Charlie Haas so aggressive and going right after John Morrison, a punch right to the temple, and that'll get your attention.
Haas is a mat-based wrestler, needs the ground of John Morrison. And the speed and quickness of John Morrison is what Haas has got to combat somehow, some way.
What's Morrison thinking here? I don't think Haas could figure it out either.
John Morrison is an offensive innovator. Going from the outside back in through the ropes. Is quickening the pace here. Hey, that's a very strategic maneuver by the Seton Hall graduate, Charlie Haas.
Listen to this impact as Morrison's leg was swept.
Steel steps are very unforgiving.
Not forgiving at all.
As is Charlie Haas at the moment. Haas has got his game face on and a hard kick after the stairs. The kick right to the torso.
Right to those ribs of John Morrison. And now Haas going for his first cover in a two count. And John Morrison entering this contest has to be sky high. A win over the World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, he probably was a little euphoric going into this match. I would say the euphoria has evaporated at the moment.
It's been kicked right out of him by Charlie Haas.
Talk about all the trades and, of course, all the information on that big blockbuster trade. 15 individuals involved on WWE.com. As we speak, and look at Morrison fight back.
And Haas is sometimes... Tag team partner Sheldon Benjamin has been traded now to ECW.
Morrison must have thought Haas's head was a soccer ball, that Pele kick.
And Morrison building up momentum, which is never a good thing for his opponent.
Good night.
John Morrison from Los Angeles, California. About as physically fit as one man can be. Puts in the time in the gym. Despite all the flash and style of John Morrison, not afraid to get his hands dirty.
Morrison spending most of his training time on the mat, where it's important. And Morrison, there it is.
That is Starship Pain, ladies and gentlemen. One, two, three, Morrison wins again.
Morrison is a young, exciting, creative individual that we're honored to have on Friday Night SmackDown and here tonight on WGN America. Keep your eye on John Morrison. He's going to soar higher and higher.
He is the guru of greatness, and once again tonight, he is a winner. And ladies and gentlemen, ECW's brashest superstar, Zack Ryder, is headed to the ring and is in action next.
Welcome back to WWE Superstars, and you're looking at the homepage from WWE.com following the Bash. And of course, we'd like to thank the WWE Universe for being a part of the Bash.
We'd also like to give a special thanks to Aranda for Why You Want to Bring Me Down. It's the official Bash theme song. It's off their self-titled album, which is available now. It's also a run-on sentence.
Making his way to the ring from Long Island, New York, weighing in at 214 pounds, Zack Ryder.
Well, here comes the flamboyant, arrogant, and impressive woo-woo-woo man, Josh.
Welcome, everyone, to ECW's contribution to WWE Superstars. And, Matt, thanks to our general manager, Tiffany, we are about to see a brand new superstar as a result of the new Superstar Initiative.
Certainly going to be exciting here as Zack Ryder, the woo-cubed man.
Woo-cubed.
Yeah, woo.
A little free, a small free.
And from Laguna Beach, California, weighing in at 252 pounds,
what you spoke of, Josh, part of the new Superstar Initiative from ECW every Tuesday night on Sci-Fi. This young man from the West Coast, Tyler Reks.
I know that Tyler Reks is kind of like a surfer kind of dude, if I could say so.
Tyler Reks has that laid-back West Coast SoCal style.
Okay, likes to drink wheatgrass, take granola, listen to Jack Johnson records.
What are you talking about?
How do you think he voted on Proposition 8?
But I tell you what, Tyler Reks will not be laid back when the bell rings, that's for sure.
Well, yeah, not me. You know, it's funny, some call Zack Ryder a tool. Did you know that the term tool is actually an old surfer term? It's used for the guys that would sit on the beach and fix and wax their boards but never actually get into the water.
I tell you, superstars right here, they're the polar opposites.
Oh.
Tyler Reks quickly into the cover.
What do you think's on Tyler Reks' calendar for his plans for 4th of July?
How different are they from Zack Ryder's plans? Zack Ryder will be in the clubs, hanging out in Long Island. Tyler Reks will probably be on a surfboard somewhere.
Zack Ryder's going to pop his collar, wear his sunglasses at night. A little Corey Hart reference. But you can say what you will about Zack Ryder. He certainly is impressive and aggressive. Getting on Zack Ryder.
Cover by Ryder. We talk about the aggressive streak in Zack Ryder every time he gets in the ring. And we've been impressed by Zack Ryder. And the aggression of Zack Ryder, you see it right here, right in your living room.
Hey, you listen to me. You got that
Reks making his debut right here on WWE Superstars.
Oh, Tyler Reks has the size and the agility. Now we get to see perhaps what this young man Tyler Reks is made of. Wow, that was innovative.
Puts together a series of moves. Cover on Zack Ryder.
Two.
That's a little easy there, isn't it? He's smart. That's smart from Zack Ryder. Perfectly legal as well. Devastating. That's the Zack attack. That's two. Yes. Boy.
Here is your winner, Zack Ryder.
Zack Ryder's goofy looking face. No, he won.
No. You go tell him he's goofy, man. That's a face of what some would call a tool. It's the face of a winner here tonight on WWE Superstars. Don't make that face, Zack.
Can't argue with that, but take a look at the boot earlier from Zack Ryder.
Just can't see it coming. Tyler looks good here, though. His size and agility come into play. Quickness as well. But the turning point in the match comes here. Cunning aptitude from Long Island Zack Ryder, who's about to turn this into a victory. Just watch Tyler Reks' neck. Oof. It takes more than physical capability to be a superstar. Let's take a look at what some of the WWE superstars are doing heading into SummerSlam.
While the superstars and divas of the WWE will rule the stage at SummerSlam, it will be the youth of America who will steal the show with their commitment to broadening their horizons as part of the SummerSlam Reading Jam. The WWE has teamed up with more than 500 libraries nationwide to encourage children and teens alike to visit their local libraries and read throughout the summer.
World Wrestling Entertainment really has helped put the library on the map and noticed a lot more kids coming in.
World Wrestling Entertainment is proud to contribute to the education of America's youth.
Anytime I have an opportunity to interact with children in a positive way, that's more rewarding than I have words to express. And I always have words to express.
It's been said that reading is fundamental, but the WWE Superstars make reading just plain fun.
Still to come, our main event tonight on Superstars from SmackDown. Some say that CM Punk took shortcuts to become the World Heavyweight Champion. Others have Punk's hard work and dedication. Well, tonight, Edge goes one-on-one with the World Heavyweight Champion CM Punk in our main event. On Superstars for Monday Night Raw.
What about Christian? I know you're fond of Captain Crunch, but hey, he's Captain Charisma. He's the best.
I'll tell you what's been the best as of late. Monday Night Raw, the past couple of weeks, record ratings, controversy abound, including this past Monday night. Let's take you back to Monday Night Raw.
The Raw Rebound is brought to you by WWE Mobile. Download Batista's ringtone at m.wwe.com.
Trump instituted behind my back this goofy concept of no general manager on Raw. No. That's been replaced by a weekly guest host that has the same authority as a general manager, but a different one each and every week. It could be a celebrity of some kind. It could be the man on the street. So the guest host for the night, the Animal, Dave Batista.
You shouldn't have come back, Batista. What are you, a glutton for punishment? What exactly do you think is stopping the three of us from marching down to that ring and tearing the rest of you apart?
Well, nothing, I guess. Except that if you even look at me the wrong way, I'm gonna fire all three of you. Vince told me that I'd have unlimited power, which means I can make your life a living nightmare.
Raw acquired 5 new superstars, but I'm only gonna have you face 3 of them in a 3-on-1 gauntlet match.
Randy, you are on your own.
Question is who is the first opponent?
The high flyer from ECW, Evan Bourne, is now a part of Monday Night Raw.
This is a huge opportunity for Evan Bourne, and I can assure you, he will make the most of it.
Evan Bourne, that
look at this
high-octane offense.
Look at
did you see that?
Now,
Evan
what's
Bourne,
this?
He's going for airborne, and Randy Orton realizing it.
Oh my God!
And now, Randy Orton's next opponent is
the ref for the weary
WCW champion.
You can see it in Orton's eyes. What has Batista done to me?
Randy, I've always liked you. I've always respected you. And on my first night on Raw, I wanted to leave a lasting impression.
Orton's gotten through two stages of the gauntlet match. One he didn't even have to work at.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Randy Orton's final opponent.
Look at Orton's eyes! Look at Orton's face! Oh, no!
The near 400-pound Mark Henry.
I think Orton is getting sick in the stomach.
Randy, just like Jack Swagger, I came here on my first night on Raw to make an impression. And it's gonna be a good one.
Looks like no reprieve from Mark Henry.
Whoa! Strongest slam. Mark Henry has pinned the WWE champion.
Batista gotta be pretty proud of himself.
Orton was made to run the gauntlet, and he paid the price.
If Randy Orton didn't have enough problems already, this coming Monday night on Raw, he sits back to find out who he defends his WWE title against at Night of Champions. Two of the greatest superstars in WWE history square off. Triple H versus John Cena in the Night of Champions tournament final. The winner will face Randy Orton for the WWE title at Night of Champions.
Certainly a huge Monday night in store for us this Monday, but tonight, our main event right around the corner, CM Punk, our World Heavyweight Champion, in action against Edge. And, well, to say the bash was controversial for CM Punk would be a huge understatement.
Let's take you back to this past Sunday, ladies and gentlemen, at the bash, and show you just what we're talking about. Jeff Hardy thought that he had won the world title, and so did all of us, quite frankly. Well, that's Swanton, but if you keep an eye on CM Punk, how close he is to the bottom rope. He will play, that will be the story in this pinfall.
It was a 1-2-3, no doubt about it. The bell rung, but then the referee noticed where CM Punk's left leg was.
It was like being out of bounds. CM Punk was out of bounds before the three count. So then the match had to officially restart. And as the match restarted, it was a flurry of action. Jeff Hardy knew he was in trouble in the go-to-sleep position, but then he caught Punk errantly, inadvertently, right in the eye.
And oof, this is where the big controversy comes in. CM Punk kicked the referee in the back. According to CM Punk, it was completely accidental.
Well, Punk's vision obviously was impaired. Jeff Hardy could not believe it. And after the match certainly went ballistic, as we all saw. And obviously, I should add, rightfully so.
This contest is a football. Approaching the ring from Chicago, Illinois. Weighing 222 pounds, is the World Heavyweight Champion, CM Punk.
And to follow up, what happened at the bash, CM Punk technically lost the match, but because it was not a pinfall or submission, CM Punk retained his World Heavyweight Championship.
And coming up next, the World Heavyweight Champion, CM Punk, will collide with the Ultimate Opportunist Edge. What a main event. We've got it for you next.
We're back on WWE Superstars here on WGN America, and we're all set for one of the biggest main events in this program's history, the World Heavyweight Champion, CM Punk, set for battle.
This is your name.
Our chairman and Theodore Long made the tag title match, the Colognes, of course, against Rhodes and DiBiase, a three-team match. And the opportunist Edge and Chris Jericho took a major opportunity.
A triple threat match at the Bash, and Edge and Chris Jericho are now the undisputed tag team champions.
And of course, ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, that the undisputed tag team champions can compete on any brand. They can appear like tomorrow night on Friday Night SmackDown on My Network TV. They can be here on WGN America, of course, on Monday Night Raw, UCW, wherever. Undisputed means they go to any brand to defend those tag titles.
And Edge and Jericho are only the second undisputed tag team champions ever. Carlito and Primo held those titles since WrestleMania 25. Look at Punk being aggressive.
Well, it's going to be really interesting. Both these men have had emotional weeks. This past Sunday, CM Punk, who's still, I believe, has some issues with his eye. I'm not sure, but...
Well, that may have been why Punk was so aggressive. Edge may have gotten a shot in on Punk's eye.
Edge and Jericho go to the Bash, get put together in a moment's notice, and come out the undisputed tag team champion.
If I'm not mistaken, that's the exact same official that disqualified CM Punk after Punk kicked him in the back at the Bash.
Punk doing a pretty good job right now. Those Muay Thai kicks on the thigh of the former world champion. A man that says he's essentially naked without the world title around his waist, Edge.
And Punk going to go for a cover here. Has the leg hooked briefly as Edge kicks out. And JR, what's next for these undisputed tag team champs? Chris Jericho and Edge, in your mind, can they coexist together?
Well, it's going to be challenging. Quite frankly, a lot of egos involved in Edge and Christian. And I would like to add also, ladies and gentlemen, that after the Bash on Sunday night, that Punk went to this official that's officiating here tonight and apologized for his actions, that the kick was inadvertent, that Punk's vision was impaired.
And now another cover.
And Punk certainly did not intend to kick the official. That's the story that we're getting. And I have no reason not to believe that, quite frankly.
Well, Jeff Hardy, I'm sure, tells a different story, JR.
I'm sure that he would. And I can understand Jeff's angst and his emotional state that he's in.
And now look at Edge with a roll-up. And if you're Jeff Hardy, you're thinking, what else can go wrong? So many times, Hardy has just touched the edge of the brass ring, so to speak, and had it taken away by CM Punk. As another cover here, and a two this time.
Both these men are moving gingerly only 4 days after the Bash. Well, Jeff Hardy has been at the top of the mountain. He just hasn't resided there long enough to satisfy himself or his legion of fans in the WWE universe.
Punk nearly threw Edge over the top rope, and down on that ring apron goes Edge. Some momentum, a baseball slide sends Edge crashing to the floor.
This is a one fall non-title match. Our main event here tonight on WGN America.
You can see again. Tending to that eye. Ooh, what a boot.
That boot may have gone right in that same eye, the area, that injured eye, and that Punk's vision is not going to be any improved after that exchange with Edge. The safety of the athletes, the officials, the first responsibility.
Well, will this match continue, ladies and gentlemen? CM Punk, obviously in a lot of pain. We'll find out next. We're back on WWE Superstars, and the match has continued, JR.
And Edge now doing a good job of taking the ultimate opportunity to beat the world's champion in this one-fall non-title matchup, perhaps catching Punk on a good night.
Well, Edge, of all the superstars in SmackDown, Raw, or ECW, the one guy you don't want to face when you're wounded is Edge, because you know he will take advantage of an injury.
That's smart. Nothing wrong with exploitation of an injury in this arena. Nice one-man flapjack. How could it be two?
And now a cover from Edge. And Punk not only has to be concerned about the arsenal that Edge brings to each and every match, but also about his obviously wounded eye.
Well, it's just hard to maintain one's focus when you're suffering an injury, certainly in such a delicate area as one's eye. Yes. Edge taking full advantage of this opportunity here tonight. And certainly CM Punk has heard it from all fronts. You know, has CM Punk been truly judged fairly this week since the bash on Sunday? I bet you a rack of ribs somewhere tonight, someplace, Jeff Hardy is watching this match here tonight on WGN America.
And Jeff Hardy might be enjoying what he's seeing at the moment. Not that Jeff Hardy's Edge's biggest fan. Remember the ladder match those two squared off in at Extreme Rules. Jeff Hardy won that match, became the World Heavyweight Champion for about a minute, and then CM Punk cashed in that Money in the Bank contract.
Certainly Jeff Hardy showed us his emotion, how badly he wants to be the champion, but absolutely ballistic after the controversial decision on Sunday. CM Punk now starting to mount some offense. We know Jeff Hardy's passion is to be the world's champion. And CM Punk is just as passionate to keep it. Punk pushed up ladder in Zaguri, got a near fall, and Punk has battled his way back into this match.
And back to Jeff Hardy, seems that Jeff felt that CM Punk intentionally struck the referee with that kick and intentionally got disqualified. But CM Punk has simply said that's not true. Hooking the leg is Edge in a two count.
Certainly nothing inadvertent about that DDT. Edge's eyes are clear and focused, both of them. Can't say the same thing for CM Punk here tonight.
And once again, the championship can only change hands on a pinfall or submission. That was not the case Sunday at the bash. Look at Edge, setting up for the spear. CM Punk saw it coming. And now Punk with a cover. Two, no. And how about that strategy by the World Heavyweight Champion?
CM Punk made a great counter, perhaps out of desperation, and desperation may be setting in on Punk as he's thinking about something high risk on the outside on the apron. The springboard misses.
Oh, and a quick slam. Punk, two. And Punk saying, wasn't that a three? I'm hitting Edge with everything I've got.
Very competitive matchup here tonight. And that running knee is so effective.
And then Punk. Oh, is Edge going to sleep?
Oh, Edge raking the eyes.
You're right.
Edge raked the eyes, and he dug his fingers right into that injured eye of CM Punk. And that was not inadvertent, I don't think at all. Edge taking advantage of a wounded man here. And Edge is lashing out at Punk, and I don't know that Punk can even see his adversary.
That's it. What does that mean?
I can't see. Ladies and gentlemen, CM Punk is unable to continue. Therefore, the winner of this match as a result of a forfeit, the Rated R Superstar is...
Well, JR, CM Punk simply could not continue.
And this is really a surprising development. You saw that Punk actually weighed the match off himself, telling the official that he could not defend himself. He could not continue.
No loss. Well, here's how it all went down at the end. Punk with that running knee right into the jaw of Edge, and then was setting up for what appeared to be a bulldog, and then the go to sleep, but Edge powers out, and then it looked like a rake to the eyes.
I think that's quite obvious, as our colleague Josh Matthews is going to try to get a word with the world's champion.
CM Punk, obviously your eye is injured, but my question for you is, Would you have done the same thing if this were a title match? Would you have forfeit?
You know, obviously you're right. My eye's a little bit injured right now. In fact, a little bit's an understatement. I don't want to forfeit anything ever, but if I can't see, I can't compete. When my eye's better, I'll be happy to give Edge a rematch. Right now, I can't see right now.
Punk, thank you for your time, and I wish you a speedy recovery. Thank you.
So the world heavyweight champion basically gave up in the main event tonight, said I cannot continue, my eye is too damaged.
Well, I tell you, I know the competitive Punk is. I can only imagine how much it hurts CM Punk's pride here tonight to have to wave this one off. But as he said, when he gets healthy, he'll be glad to give Edge another opportunity.
Let's take one more look at what happened. Punk on the verge of perhaps hitting the go-to-sleep, and Edge breaking the eyes of the world heavyweight champion, and Punk could not continue.
I've never seen anyone quite give up like that, quite frankly.